Alright, so we'll be discussing about protein structure and function. So, what proteins are? I want to know more from you. Of the previous lecture. And the reason behind it, because I want you to, I know that you guys are very busy, so you have to study a lot for many subjects, but I want you to please go through the lecture once after the class. Okay? And so this exam has some points. And at the end, you have 2 marks all together. From these points. So I will write down some points and the beauty of that exam will be you will take the exam and you will by yourself correct the marking. Okay? Your exam. But not your paper, maybe your friend's paper. So one group will be this and the other group will be this. And I will select the paper from here and give it to you. Mark and we will also answer and then you have to honestly mark your friend's paper. Okay? So, and at the end, overall 2 marks you will get from all these points. Okay? And so it's not without any number. You will get the number as well. But at the same time, I would like you to get prepared and read the lecture that you go through once. Okay?
And it will not be so much burden to you, I hope so. And okay, so there are 3 stages of polypeptide chain. Actually what happened initially when the sequence of the amino acids has been known and there are lots of from the advent of the DNA recombinant technology, there are millions of the sequence of protein and primary sequence. And primary sequence are just the sequence of amino acids, how they are connected, which amino acid is first, second, third, you know that connection of the amino acids. And these are the primary structures. And but the family sequence doesn't describe about the function. There are still people are trying to make different software which you can describe the structure or the sequence of the amino acids and it will give you the structure prediction and the function prediction. But so far it's not so much successful. So there are still methods that people are using to determine the structure, three-dimensional structure of the protein, and that three-dimensional structure, when you have the structure of the protein, then you can exactly figure out the function relationship. And the techniques that people are using to determine the structure are X-ray crystallography, most widely used technique when you see the structures in protein data bank, you can see that X-ray crystallography has been widely used and about the hyperlimitation because the protein has to be crystallized, but in the end the size range is not limited. And the second is NMR spectroscopy, which is about, I would say, about 82% of the structures are including the NMR and called by the X-ray cytoplasm. And about 12-13% of the structures has been solved using NMR spectroscopy. It's more complicated technique, but you can get more closer look of the native conformation of the protein since it is in solution. Now there is a solid state NMR because there are proteins that are that are not easy to crystallize, or it is could not crystallize them, especially membrane proteins, and it's not easy to solidize them. And there are just in when you try to get it, you can get in the form of solid. So that's right. Another NMR method, that is solid state NMR, has been developed and it is quite easy. We have another institute, so we use instrument as well, in which you can record the data for X-ray. And the other, we have 13 superconducting NMR spectrometers, including 800 megahertz NMR spectrometers. And our institute has invested a lot. This one equipment that required in December 2015 cost $2 million. So it's really very, very expensive equipment, and you should, while you are here in the institute, you should try to use this technique. Or at least learn this whenever you can get an opportunity to work on this later in your life. And the other technique that is now emerging is the electron microscopy. You know, it's a very fascinating technique, a very huge instrument. It's very much expensive, about 10 times more expensive than an NMR system. So you can multiply $3 million that expense. So this is very much expensive system that people are now using, and as a matter of fact, in 2017, the Nobel Prize was awarded. Actually, this is the technique in which, you know, I think most of the Nobel Prize has been awarded to develop new techniques, instruments, and techniques to determine the structures of protein, you know. And this structure was caused by electron microscope. As well as huge molecules like 16 point something mega dalton protein. So it's a huge molecule. And they get the structure up to 4.5 angstrom, which is very close to the atomic level. So, and over the years, several Nobel Prizes have been given in this field. So, coming back to the protein family structure, actually, initially, it was thought when the first protein structure was determined, it was thought to people were interesting, but to like DNA strands, protein structure would be so simple. Like the DNA, that when they got the first protein structure, it was really complicated structure. And it was in early 1950s, it was reported. And the scientist actually reported that he found an undesirable complexity, because people were not, so you can think, it's not very old technique. So UV spectroscopy has developed 200 years ago. IR developed
about 1 to 2 years. So it's not that old technique to get the structure of the dimension surface. And so people are used to think that the structures of proteins should be simple because they are obviously the amino acids that we find. And but when they got the structures are very complicated. And that is the reason. It's the primary structure, the primary sequence of the protein actually helps to determine the three-dimensional structure of the protein. But even then we need different techniques to get the real structure. The software techniques are the software that has been developed so far, and they are fully available. You can Google and you can find by yourself. And they are not used. You can't get the even closer structure what has been reported. So we back to our main topic. And I need a pointer. It doesn't have pointer. Alright, so primary sequence or primary structure of the protein are just the protein structure, protein sequence of sequence of amino acids that they are joined to each other in polypeptide, making polypeptide bonds. Okay, and so the primary sequence is encoded by DNA and it is transcribed into mRNA. It actually, as I told you, defines the three-dimension fold of the structure. And definitely, when it is folded, then it defines the functional properties. Doesn't work. Okay, in secondary structure, what secondary structure includes? It includes alpha helices, beta sheets, and turns, loop, disulfide bond, and phi psi angle. We will study about all these contacts. And there are main chain and side chain torsion angles. So this is the primary sequence. You can see just only the sequence of amino acids. There are one letter code and there are three letter codes. So I think for this class at least you need to memorize the structure of amino acids and one letter code. Okay? So and these are the secondary structures, alpha helices and beta sheets. And then the secondary structure, these are secondary structure elements. They fold. So it forms the tertiary structure. Okay? And when the same molecule, like two similar polypeptide chains or more than two polypeptide chains come closer, so they form to perform a certain function, then it becomes a quaternary structure. Okay, so there are in nature. This is the most simple amino acid, which is glycine, and in glycine, because you can see here, the side chain is also a hydrogen. Okay, so you don't have its direct hindrance. And that is why the glycine, whenever it is present in more frequently in the amino system, then it gives a certain conformation to the polypeptide chain. And this is alanine, which has nothing. Side chain is better. So all the amino acids has, this is the alpha carbon. Alpha carbon, or let me explain to you here. So there are different representations, okay? So this is the alpha carbon. Alpha carbon are those in which a functional group is attached, okay? So
this alpha carboxyl group and the imine group is attached to the alpha carbon. And there is a hydrogen also attached to alpha carbon. And in glycine, you have a cycline, a hydrogen in the form of the cycline. So you have actually two hydrogen attached to alpha carbon. In alanine, you can see this hydrogen is replaced by a methyl. And so these are the most simplest ones. Okay, so there are actually L direction and the yes, and you can see here, you know, this is the alpha carbon, okay, and this is the carboxyl group, and this is amine group, and this is the R group, okay. And you can see it's a number 1, number 2, number 3. This is the number 4, the hydrogen. So these are 4 groups which is attached to the alpha carbon. We are talking about one amino acid. So do you know about on which basis the priority is being given? Okay, the priority is being given, this is 1, number 2, number 3 and number 4. And you know, the hydrogen is on the back side and that's why it's moving like this. Okay? So, on which basis the priority is being given? It's moving anti-clockwise. And if you want to move clockwise, kya hoga? Kya aap isko is tarah plan kar de? So ye clockwise move hona shuru ho jayega. Atomic number. Okay, so nitrogen has 7, carbon has 6. Okay, so priority is being given to nitrogen. And this R group, whatever it would be, oxygen to nahi hoga. Oxygen hoga kya yahan par? Kisi bhi amino acid mein, this R group. R group is a side chain. If in case of glycine, this would be a in case of alanine, this would be methyl. Jo bhi next amino acids hai, wo is carbon, there should be a carbon here. Theek hai na, wo uske saath extend honge. Side chain extend hogi. We will discuss and see the amino acid sequence and structure as well. So, R group should be carbon. Theek hai, agree? Okay. So, this carbon and this is also a carbon, both are carbon. So, humne isko 2 diya, isko 3 diya. Hai na? So, highest priority 1 is nitrogen, amine group. Agree? Number 2 and number 3, why is this?
The reason, if you have two carbons attached to the alpha carbon, so then we need to see the next atom attached to it. Okay? Ye jo next atom hai, iske saath, wo kaun sa hai? Oxygen. इसके साथ नेक्स्ट आइटम कौन सा होगा अगर एलएनएम की बात करते हैं? हाइड्रोजन. तो प्रायोरिटी शुड बी गिवन कार्बन. ठीक है, समझ आ गई? सो दिस इज 1, 2 एंड नंबर 3 एंड दिस इज काउंटर क्लॉकवाइज. नाउ दिस इज द थिंग. ठीक है ना, ये इसी तरह है ना. ये नीम है, कार्बन ग्रुप, कार्बन ग्रुप लगा हुआ है एक यहाँ पर, एलएनएम. ठीक है, ये नंबर 1 है, नंबर 2 है, नंबर 3 है, इसमें इट विल मूव लाइक है ना. ओके, हम अगर इसकी प्रायोरिटी को इसको काउंटर क्लॉक वाइज देकर क्लॉक वाइज मूव करना चाहते हैं, तो प्रायोरिटी हमें डिस्टेंस करनी होगी और वो प्रायोरिटी ऐसे डिस्टेंस नहीं हो सकती. यू हैव टू ब्रेक द बॉन्ड. देर इज नो अदर वे कि हम इसको रिपेट करें और इसकी प्रायोरिटी डिफरेंट हो जाए. उनके नहीं. ठीक है, ये नंबर 1 है, ये नंबर 2 है और ये नंबर 3 है. कुछ भी करें ये इसी तरह ही मूव होगा क्योंकि ये इसी डायरेक्शन में ही मूव हो सकता है. क्योंकि नंबर 1 जब तक कि हम इसको तोड़ के कहीं और ना पाते, जब तक बॉन्ड ब्रेक नहीं होगा उसकी रोटेशन चेंज नहीं होगी. समझाया? ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गिव, अच्छा आप इसको काउंटर क्लॉक से क्लॉक वाइज मूव करना चाहते हैं, सो व्हाट शुड वी डू, क्या करना चाहिए, कौन सा ग्रुप लगा हटा के कहाँ लगा? इसको हम यहाँ करेंगे, ये नंबर 1 हो जाएगा. ठीक है, ये नंबर 2 हो जाएगा. सही, ये क्या होगा? करके देखते हैं. सही, ये आप कह रहे हैं. नंबर 1, ठीक है, नंबर 2 एंड नंबर 3. अभी कैसे मूव होगा? इस तरह जाएगा. 1 कहा है? ये 1 है. 1 देन 2 एंड देन 3. ठीक है, सो नाउ यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट चेंज ऑफ रोटेशन फ्रॉम डी टू एल इज नॉट पॉसिबल विदाउट ब्रेकिंग अप. अभी तो हमने यहां से बोल के यहां लगा दिया है, मगर एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट हमने क्या किया है, तो हमने बॉन्ड ब्रेक किया है ना. सो विदाउट ब्रेकिंग अ बॉन्ड इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. ये आप लोगों को देखू, आपको देखू, ठीक है, इसमें सही. एनी क्वेश्चन सो फार?
Double bond, it's not moved.
you know, for example, here, the method, right? ये ऐसे मूव करता रहेगा जैसे सिंगल बॉन्ड ये कार्बोनल है और इट कांट मूव ये रिस्ट्रिक्ट हो गया ओके जब रिस्ट्रिक्ट हो जाए तो मूवमेंट स्टॉप हो जाए यू शुड हैव डबल बॉन्ड ट्रिपल बॉन्ड और डबल बॉन्ड हैच करेक्टर व्हेन यू वांट टू रिस्ट्रिक्ट द राइट और अदरवाइज सिंगल बॉन्ड इज ऑलवेज मतलब What I'm going to, what I was trying to actually explain to you, that the clockwise and anti-clockwise movement, rotation, change in position, only possible when you break a bond. Okay, so you know this is carbon, which has four different group is attached, and then with the carbon there are four different groups is attached called chiral carbon. Okay, so chiral carbon is very important phenomena in determining the structure, three-dimensional structure. So since it has four different groups, so each carbon of amino acid is a chiral one. Okay, and the rotation, the L and D conformation, or change in the conformation. Only possible when you break a bond. You know, so rotate करते हैं जो आपके पास model है इस तरह चाहे rotate करें आप जो counter clockwise clockwise में सिर्फ rotate करने से नहीं change कर सकते you need to change the priority you know priority change करने के लिए you have to change you know break the bond जो इधर से उधर लगा रहे हैं ठीक है Okay, so we give the number this n because this atomic number is 7. Carbon number is 6. So that's why we give we look at the atomic number and give the priority. The highest atomic number is the number one priority. Okay, among all these three, you have to have structure. Suppose it's a matrix. Okay, so number one would be this and these two are carbon. Okay, both are carbon. Both have number six. Then we have to look at the second atom attached to the carbon. So looking at that atom, we find that there is oxygen attached to it and there is a hydrogen. So that's why we give number two priority here. Okay? And we always, whenever you look at the structure like this, you always need to fold the hydrogen from the back side, you know. When you look, like this is the image, you know. This hydrogen is always on the back side. Then you can actually correctly assign the clockwise and anti-clockwise. Okay?
The length of the arc and the non matter in this regard, right?
No. Right now, the length of the arc matters when there is a three dimension. So we are talking about the conformation of a single amino acid. Okay, abo arc hai. For example, if this is the lysine, so there are CH2, 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 and X2, right? So it's a long chain. Right, but this is CH2. So second one and then CH2. So CH2, CH2. When we look at these two, so carbon has one carbon attached and two hydrogen attached. So again the priority would be given to carbon.
Yeah.
Yes, in nature. No, actually by in nature has selected this. So naturally occurring amino acids and proteins. You know, these are
एक्चुअली मेरा निर्णय नहीं है, उसका आया था आपने बी और एल से है, बीजा मेरा नहीं है एग्जैक्टली इफ यू हैव अ मिरर यू कैन फाइंड एग्जैक्टली द सेम बट इट अ डिस्टिंक्ट नेचर एंड नेचर हैज सेलेक्टेड बट इन लैब यू कैन सिंथेसाइज बोथ. As a matter of fact, in the Skills Research Institute, a group actually synthesized an enzyme using amino acids, both complete full enzyme using B amino acid and one enzyme using L amino acid. So they were assuming these two polypeptide chains should be the mirror image, and they found it exactly. So they find there are two enzymes, one made up of B amino acid and the other made up of L amino acid. The enzyme, the C-dimensional structure, are actually a mirror image. Same wahi hogi na. Ek to hydrogen jo piche hai, wo to wahi rahega. Sahi hai. So priority between hydrogen and carbon. ऑलवेज बी योर कार्बन है ना. हाइड्रोजन का कितना होता है कार्बन से, ठीक है. ओके, दीज आर द डिफरेंट प्रेजेंटेशन इन विच द अमीनो एसिड कैन बी रिटेन. दीज आर द डिफरेंट प्रोजेक्शन. If you want to write in a plane, you can write like this. This is carbon, alpha carbon. You have a carboxyl group, an amine group, a hydrogen, a methyl, right? And this is a cycle. Then you can write like this. You know, this is the structure. In three-dimensional structure, when you write on the paper, you can write like this. These two bonds, which are bold bonds, it actually means pointing towards you, okay, outward. And the bonds which are dotted bonds, it means they are pointing on the back of the page. So aapke paas hai model, usko bhi karke dekh sakte hain, theek hai. So these are the just different projection. Okay, now there are different ways to look at the polypeptide chain. What we have looked so far is alpha carbon, okay, amino group, carboxylic group, and side chain. And this is the same here. You know, this is the R group, alpha carbon, amino group, carboxylic group, and what this bond is, peptide bond. Okay. How the peptide bond is formed? It's a condensation reaction. Hai na? Condensation mein kya hota hai? Number of water molecules. So, it means this is the carboxylic group, OH, COOH. There is OH and this is NH2. So, H and OH has been removed and a bond is formed. So this is the peptide bond. And you know, as a matter of fact, this peptide bond, since this is the double bond, okay, and oxygen has lone pairs of electrons on it. Okay, when oxygen has lone pair of electrons, so it means it can donate the electron here and the these electrons can move here. Hana? So it means these, all this bond becomes N, T, and O. It is on the plane. Because double bond character will come. Do you understand what I mean?
So you have a board here. Do you have
a board here? Do you have a अभी इसके साथ मिले हैं ना उसको मिले ऑनली वी आर लुकिंग एट द पेप्टाइड फॉर्म ओके व्हाट इज हैपनिंग एक्चुअली ओके इट हैज नो पेप्टाइड फॉर्म ये जिस इलेक्ट्रॉन हियर बट इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑलवेज द एलिमेंट जो है व्हेन देयर इज अ डबल बॉन्ड देन इज ऑलवेज द एलिमेंट सो इट मींस this double bond. Bond actually is a carrying of two electrons. It's a bond here. So then it moves here. Okay? Jab itna hi condition hogi to kya hoga? Okay. So bond se baat hai. Nitrogen also has a lone pair of electrons. It also has a lone pair of electrons, but oxygen is more electrolytic. So when it moves here, then it moves here. Okay, so this double bond and okay. Nitrogen has a lone pair of electrons. It can more easily donate as compared to oxygen. Oxygen is more electronegative. Electronegative means it can hold the electron towards it. So these lone pair of electrons, since in resonance, it donates here. Okay. When it donates here, it becomes a double bond. And nitrogen, we have the nitrogen pair kidney bond to it. Four. When there is a four bond, always gets a touch. Okay. And when it comes here, always remember that carbon cannot, unless the transition state, cannot have five bonds. Always four bonds, always. Unless it's a transition state. Some of the transition states, the carbon has five bonds. But it's not a transition state. And so it comes here, it forms a double bond, and in that case, it goes here. The oxygen, these electrons go towards the oxygen. So oxygen becomes negative. So it means this peptide bond, this CNNO, is a peptide bond, has a planar structure. So see, this bond is a double bond, it's continuously moving. अभी कोई इसमें है फिर इसमें होगा ठीक है यहाँ पे डबल बॉन्ड था फिर यहाँ पे होगा सो दिस इज ऑलवेज इन दिस फॉर्म ठीक है सो इट मीन्स वेन दिस इज द कंडीशन इट मीन्स इट हैज द प्लेरिटी दिस पेप्टाइड ग्रुप ऑलवेज प्लेयर ठीक है ये जो है हम इसकी जिसकी जो बॉन्ड लेंथ है दिस इज इन बिटवीन द सिंगल बॉन्ड एंड द डबल बॉन्ड But it has double, not exactly double bond, but double bond-like character. So that is why it is planar. And the bond length of a single bond is, I think 1.48 angstrom something. And I have somewhere written in the lecture.
Yes. Here. Okay, you can see here
that if there is amine CH2NH, the bond length is 1.45 angstrom, and if there is imine, IMIN, right? In CH double bond N, the bond length is 1.25. And in case of amide group, this is amide group, right? The group has, this is called amide group. So CONH is 1.32, somewhere in between amine and imine. And that is why it has double bond character. not exactly double bond. There is a double bond, so it should have 1.25 electrons. But it's not a single bond either. It doesn't have the bond length of 1.45. It has bond length something in between. And that is why it has a double bond character. And it will be a planar. So all the peptide bonds are planar. Okay?
Now you can see it becomes more and more complicated.
We were thinking that now seems to be looking at this simple structure. So all these are single bonds, they can easily rotate. But that is not true. It's more complicated now. Now you know that this bond, this peptide group, the rotation is restricted. Restricted, hai na? And the peptide group is everywhere. This is the peptide group here, and there is a peptide group here. So the rotation of this is restricted. Rotation of each peptide bond in the planar is a restrict rotation. While these the carbon and the carbonyl group. The angle between carbon and carbonyl, this alpha carbon and carbonyl, is called psi angle. Okay, and the angle between alpha carbon and NH is called phi angle. So, these are the single bonds, right? So single bond means it can rotate anywhere. But it is not possible in case of polypeptide chain because everywhere there is a planar structure. And there is R group as well. R group means based on the amino acid you have some steric hindrance because of the sulfur atom. Right? So you are having more and more difficulty now. Is not very simple. You have rotation restriction in phi angle as well and psi. So not all psi and phi angles are allowed. This is not possible. Why is it not possible? Because of the presence of linearity in the amide group and the presence of the R group, bulkiness of the R group. So only few rotation of phi and psi angle is allowed. And there is a calculation which was done by Indian mathematician Ramachandarn, right? And that is called, he actually plotted phi and psi angle, and it's called Ramachandarn plot. So when we look at the Ramachandarn plot, we can see that not all phi and psi angle are allowed. So you can see here, this is the region. This is the psi angle and this is the phi angle. Okay, so 0 180 plus 0 180 minus, and this is the same. So it has been plotted, psi angle against phi angle. So you can see all the beta sheet angles are over here. Means somewhere minus 80 to minus 60 somewhere, minus 60 or minus 50. And that would be the phi. And this would be, the psi angle would be around 40 to 180 in positive. And this is the region where all the beta sheets are allowed. When there is a beta sheet, all the phi and psi angles would be this. So not, 180 pe aapke paas allow hai, single bond you can move 180. You have model with you, you can move around. Okay, you can see here, all the single bonds you can move. there is no problem in when you have a single amino acid. There is no problem. But when you have a double bond like this, right, then there is a okay. So here in case of amino acids, you have restrictions which are present due to the planarity of the amide group and the presence of bulkiness of the R group. Okay, when you have alpha helix, so they are more restricted. You know, only this area is allowed. And when you have left-handed helix, sometimes you have left-handed helix. Then you can see the fine triangle. It's very rare, but even then you can find a small rectangle. But when you plot, you know, glycine. So glycine has much less restriction. It's got size is only proton or hydrogen, right? So it can occupy different places in the Ramachandran plot.
वो आसानी से मूव हो सकता है, डिफरेंट पोजीशन एक्वायर कर सकता है, ठीक है? ऑलराइट,
सो हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज द कंडेंसेशन रिएक्शन. There is a carboxylic group and this is NH3, and when they condense, a polypeptide bond is formed, and in the sequence of amino acids there is an amino group, it's free, which is on N-terminal. All the sequence is always from N to C-terminal. So amino group, one amino group at the N-terminal is free, the first amino acid ka hoga. And the last amino acid carboxylic group is free, but all the amino acids always form peptide bonds. Okay. Okay, that we have already seen the amide backbone is planar since it has the double bond character, and this is another way of looking at the polypeptide chain. You can see here, one way is to look this amino acid. Okay, agar hum beech mein se dekhe, so this is the amino acid that you are looking at it. But this is another way in which we look at the polypeptide chain from one carbon alpha to other carbon alpha. Okay, these are the two carbon alpha of different amino acids, and in between all these, this is a planar, and this, you can see the dotted line. When you actually draw a structure on plane, on board, on your notebook, you always make this kind of dotted line. It means there is a resonance here. There is no single bond and no double bond, and the bond length of CN and CO are the same. Okay, so this amide bond length is same, and that's why it is denoted as this kind of dotted line. And this alpha carbon in this presentation is actually half shared by this amino acid and half is shared by the previous amino acid. So this is the kind of representation in which, just to explain that there are only a few rotation is allowed, though there are single bonds, but not all the rotation is allowed. So rotation around the CN bond is restricted due to the double bond nature of the resonance hybrid form, CN bond. Okay. The peptide groups, the blue planar, are therefore planar. and carbonyl from N residue, NH from. Okay, so you know, N residue is called when you want to consider any residue as the first residue. So you say one N residue, and the next one would be N plus one, and the previous one would be N minus one.
Okay, this is just simple the denotation. Okay, that we have discussed already. And cysteine, another very important phenomena. You know, cysteine, this amino acid, is very important because it actually helps in stabilization of the protein molecule.
The presence of disulfide bridge stabilizes protein molecule and avoid it from being created. For example, in and what is happening? It is actually oxidative reaction. Okay? Oxidative reaction is made if a protein present in the reduced environment. For example, within the cell. Okay? So, वहाँ पे इसकी फॉर्म है, डाइसल्फाइड ब्रिज होगा कि नहीं होगा? हाँ, अच्छा होगा, कुछ होगा। ठीक, ओके। एंड राइट नाउ यू कैन सी हियर, दिस इज CH2SH, दिस ग्रुप, ओके? साइड चेन, ओनली साइड चेन, वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट एनी अदर थिंग। सो ठीक है, ये तुम्हारे पास अल्फा कार्बन है जिसके साथ ही साइड चेन लेती है. दिस इज NH एंड दिस इज कार्बोनिल ग्रुप एंड अटैच्ड वी हैव टू बी सीन द रिलेटिव राइट. सही है ना? ओके, सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ओनली द साइड चेन CH2SH. ओके, एंड टू CH2SH मींस यू टू मेक अ डाइसल्फाइड ब्रिज यू नीड टू हैव टू सिस्टीन मॉलिक्यूल टू सिस्टीन अमीनो एसिड्स right. So in the presence of oxygen it can form disulfide bond and water molecule is removed. Okay, this is the thing which is happening here. This is called disulfide bridge.
Theek hai,
this is here a disulfide bridge in oxidative environment. So in reduced environment, like within the cell, there is no disulfide bridge. Okay. Does not found in intracellular proteins because of reduced environment. And for example, this is an example like disulfide bridge present between A and B chain of insulin. Actually, helps to stabilize, and we will study also. There are some proteins in which the correct fold depends on the formation of correct disulfide bond. When the correct disulfide bond is formed, then protein forms fold correctly, and that we will study in some of classes. Okay, and it stabilizes the three-dimensional structure and doesn't found in intracellular protein. Okay, this is the same actually that we have discussed so far. So this is pi bond and psi bond. Only a few angles or rotation is allowed between the plane, and this will take more time, so I will discuss this in next class. Ramachandran plot we have discussed, and this will discuss further. Okay. And one more thing that I want to actually show to you, but I brought the more model. Right? These are the different conformations in which any peptide bond or any molecule can exist. So, this is the form which is called. This is called staggered. Why this is staggered? Because you can see this. You can see here. This there is a minimal hindrance. When you have something like this, अभी तो ये small है. क्योंकि इधर हाइड्रोजन हो गया, सही है। ये इस तरह जो आपको नॉट स्टैगर्ड है ना, दिस इज लाइक राइट। इट मीन्स यू मे इफ यू हैव अ बिग बुक यू हैव अ स्टैरिक हिंड्रेंस हियर, यू हैव अ स्टैरिक हिंड्रेंस हियर एंड यू हैव अ स्टैरिक हिंड्रेंस हियर। इफ यू मूव लाइक दिस यू नो देख सकते हैं आप, हाँ, इफ यू मूव लाइक दिस सो यू हैव मोर स्पेस बिटवीन दीज ग्रोव्स राइट। सो दिस कंफर्मेशन इज कॉल्ड स्टैगर्ड कंफर्मेशन। So now look at the other molecules. See, ये तीन molecules हैं, ये model में आपने आपको देखना है, ठीक है, आपको बताना है कि which one is more stable, सही। और okay, so you have This is the, ये है आपके पास, ठीक है। और ये मॉडल मैं आप लोगों को दे दूंगा, सही है, ये वापस कर देने वाला है, मगर आप लोग इसे देखेंगे, ठीक है। आप लोग मुझे बताएंगे नेक्स्ट क्लास में कि आपको कौन सा वाला इन तीनों में से ज्यादा स्टेबल लगता है, जो ज्यादा स्टेबल होगा वही एग्जिस्ट करेगा, है ना, क्योंकि लोअर एनर्जी होगी, स्टेबल है लोअर एनर्जी है तो उसके साथ एग्जिस्ट करेगा, ठीक है। ये इसका मॉडल है जो नीचे वाले का डी सी एन डी,
ठीक है। ये आपको मुझे बताना है, ये मैंने प्रेजेंटेशन यहाँ सेव कर दी है और देन
आप ये मुझे बताना है।
स्टैगर्ड
कंफर्मेशन इज मोर स्टेबल, नॉट स्टैगर्ड मीन ये इधर भी ये एक दूसरे करीब होगी ना, आप लोगों के पास आप देखें,
अगर यहाँ पे हाइड्रोजन नहीं मेथल होता तो क्या होता, बिग ग्रुप हियर बिग ग्रुप हियर बिग ग्रुप, यहाँ सब बिग बिग ग्रुप होते, ठीक है, सब एक दूसरे से स्टेरिक हिंड्रेंस कर रहे होते साइज की, ठीक है। मोस्ट ज्यादा स्पेस कहाँ मिलेगी ग्रुप को एक दूसरे से, जब ये स्टैगर्ड कंफर्मेशन
के बाद मॉडल है, आप लोगों को देखने को जवाब
देना।
नो दे हैव अ डिफरेंट फॉर्म, दे विल नॉट परफॉर्म सेम, क्योंकि जो एंजाइम्स हैं दे आर वेरी वेरी स्पेसिफिक, यू नो दे आर very selective, very specific, they act on this a particular type of conformation of a molecule, are going to change their set either. So their function, definitely alters. Since in trance is a different thing, that is around us. No, staggered means you just want to look at the size of the book. Constant space you have will be, kitne zyada space will be. It can move around. This is a single ball. So this is always moving. But zyada waqt, har confirmation is possible. When there is a single ball, it always moves, and all the confirmation, if there is 1000 confirmation, all confirmation exists. But then zyada waqt kaun si confirmation hogi? This is more sustainable. Okay? This only part of the theory. This and sound are the particular isomers. They have a particular conformation. It doesn't depend on the bulkiness of it. You have a cis conformation or a trans conformation, a particular conformation. And we will study that in case of polypeptide and especially with choline and so on. For example, in case of polypeptide chain, mostly trans more stable hota hai, theek hai, so zyada exist karta hai. So 150 to 1 ka ratio hai cis aur trans mein all amino acids ka, except proline mein 4:1. That's why cis conformation proline is very very common in amino acids. ठीक है.